Hey everybody, it's Invicta, it's time to continue our Darkest Dungeon adventure in week 57. Yeah, we skipped a couple, not skipped a couple weeks, but we had a multi-week episode last time, and this time around we have got ourselves a long run. In preparation of our fight with the hag, I'm going to be going after the Suncloak, so it's going to be a long mission. I'm going to be bringing back the same crew that we had in the last episode, with one exception. I'm going to be bringing... I will be bringing a Scrub Invicta in for this one, as Boogie is sitting out because I'm taking care of that disease. I also have a couple of people inside the sanitarium. Also, what I did off cam was that I did upgrade the final treatment ward facility to the last patient cell upgrade, which means that we have three people now in the sanitarium instead of two, which is very, very awesome indeed. Also, I'm going to go a little out of my way this time around just to make sure that we've got good camping skills here. This is something that a lot of people has been they've been asking about, and the reason why I don't want to say I don't care about the camping buffs, because I do. I mean, they are very, very important. But one thing I will say is that I don't prioritize them to be like super duper important. I mean, they are good. Don't get me wrong, they are very good. You want to have the proper synergies when it comes to your survivalist skills. And this particularly only involves the ones that actually do, like, say, stress healing. You want to have one that removes mortality debuff is good. Like, abandon all hope. Like, I never ever use that on the occultist, etc., etc. Zealous speech and zealous vigil. Both of these are very, very good for the crusader. I think that he has some of the best. He basically has some of the best camping skills in the game, and I think that's great. I don't think we need Unshakeable Leader. We'll go ahead and give him wound care, just in case. But yeah, this time around, I am going to be a little bit more aggressive as far as the camping skills synergies go. We want to do Holy Lance, we want to do Inspiring Cry. I think that, of course, we want Smite, and do we want a Stun, or do we want a Bulwark of Faith? We could try to throw out an off heal as well with Battle Heal. Battle Heal is not too bad. I think having a Stun would be nice, though. For Scrub Victa. So we're gonna drop Battle Heal. We'll go ahead and get Stunning Blow. I need to be careful with our gold consumption here, because we actually, after me putting that many people in the sanitarium, we're running a little bit low on funds. So Jeff doesn't need an upgrade there. Let's go back to the guild hall just to make sure that we've got everything there. Simply Jackson's good. Jeff, we're only going to upgrade, we'll probably only go for Finale and Slice Off for now, because I'm not planning on using solo. So everything should be two here. There you go. And yeah, we are ready to rock and roll here. Let's go ahead and get our trinkets out of the way really fast. Again, this is going to be a dark run because we want to try to get as much gold as possible. So definitely going to give our frontliners with the a little bit extra dodge. I think that putting a Brawler's Gloves in this spot is not the greatest decision. Because we are going to have a very long dark run. So I want to make sure that we have the absolute most amount of damage and crit, especially. Crit is an important thing here. So I'll go Legendary Bracer on Simply Jackson. Scrub Victa will go for Focus Ring and Dismiss's Head. Jeff can be standard that. We could go for a crit, but I'm not planning on using Jeff in any sort of offensive capability fashion. And again, of course, Dyrus is going to have Junia's Head, which is going to give us 30% extra healing skills, along with the additional 15% healing skills from the Surgeon's Charm. Now, since this is going to be a very long mission, well, technically not very long, but it is going to be a long mission, so we want to bring extra shovels. Definitely want to be bringing extra keys, just in, maybe not five keys, but we want to make sure that we have everything that we could possibly ever want on this run, especially because you don't ever want to run out of torches if you can help it. I think actually two holy waters is a little bit crazy. I think we'd be okay with one more of each of those. Maybe, do we want five keys? Five keys is a little bit silly, I think. All right, no torches. So sit back and get ready for a long, long midweek run here.
Corruption has soaked the soil, sapping all good life from these groves.
So, a pretty awful, like, god-awful room spawn that we have here. We do have... Okay, I'm just making sure. That's a really nasty starting spot, because we're literally in the smack-dab middle of the entire map.
If only treasure could staunch the flow of a
otherworldly. So since it's going to be an exterminate mission, that means we have to do basically a full clear. I don't know if anyone has ruined scrounger or anything, but figure it out. So we start off with a shuffle after a trap immediately, which is always fun. And they're going to go straight for Dyrus. Luckily, Dyrus has his dodging shoes on. Let's go ahead and... marking really does not matter. I don't want to move him back, though, because I want to get the Holy Lance off from Scrub Victa. So I'm going to go ahead and throw out the Weakening Curse. Just because they're still going to go after Dyrus, just because. And he got Rabies. Hooray. So very, very good start here. There we go. I'm not going to get the Holy Lance off now anyway, but that's okay. We'll go ahead and go for the Smite.
Another abomination.
Smite leg day. Unfortunately, Simply Jackson cannot go from the third position. Which is a little bit sad face that they get another attack on Dyrus. Luckily, he did dodge it. And, yeah. Had a lot of stress already on me. Let's drop that down a bit. Again, Dyrus can't do anything. I thought about maybe putting possibly putting the Sacrificial Stab on Dyrus, but I don't think it's that needed. I mean, Abyssal Artillery is really good, and if you can't use Abyssal Artillery, most of the time you're able to get back and just heal up whenever you need to. So we have a little bit of a juggle comp here with the finale as well as the Holy Lance. Reward
for a task well performed.
If it was anything other than Rabies, I'd probably be a little bit more motivated to camp early. Just to get rid of the disease, but I'm not that worried about it right now. I am going to heal right away, though. Nice heal by Dyrus. And I think that we can go ahead and buff everyone's speed and crit up a little bit, as well as their accuracy. And mark one of our tanks. Don't really think we have a whole lot to worry about that. Getting the leg day done. Not a very big hit there from Simply Jackson, unfortunately, but they did mark both of our tanks anyway, so that's okay. So the Fungal Scratchers have an increased likelihood of attacking a marked target, and they also deal more damage to the marked target. That's the trade-off, but again, we've got our big tough heroes up front, and that's good enough for me. I'm actually going to go ahead and buff up again. See if we can crank up the crit a little bit. Nice kill by Dyrus.
Maintain the offensive.
Nice hit by Scrub Victa, and then we should be able to get another kill on the artillery here. Even if he moves back, we can still use it if it bleeds. What is your blight resist, I wonder? 50.
Decimated.
Nice crit there by Simply Jackson. So I think delaying here for a turn is not a bad idea, just to top everyone off. Getting a little bit low, and that wasn't the greatest of heals. So we're definitely going to go for a Yop here. And then I can heal myself. Yeah, I'll go ahead and heal myself. That way Dyrus can focus a heal on Simply Jackson. Buff up everyone's accuracy and crit. We have no more stress to speak of. There's a nice heal from Dyrus. 19. Also a crit from Simply Jackson.
As the fiend falls,
much cleaner fight that time around. Now again, obviously with a long run, you have to worry about the limited inventory space at the very beginning because you have the dual firewood and you probably have more food than you need, but it's always best to have more food than you need than less food than you, well, need. Fortunately, the dog dodged. Even though he's got a dodge zero, I'm not sure how that's possible. Unless, oh no, never mind, I take that back. I was mousing over the rabble. Still gonna prioritize taking the dog out just because they deal with disease and bleed damage. We can't bloody a skeleton, so we're just gonna buff up speed and crit and accuracy again. Getting leg day done. Wayne even tells us to get back to the pit. The name of the game for this run is gold, gold, gold. We want some gold.
Be gone, fiend. Finding the stuff is only the
25
test.
Gold, I'm not too motivated in holding. That's the second random trap I've come across, though, and I'm not too happy about that either. just keep on rocking here. Now, at some point, we are going to want to camp probably at the end of this hallway, maybe. The only reason why I would do that now instead of later is because I would want to reset our light levels up, just so we don't have to worry about the Shambler possibly popping in.
Continue the onslaught. Destroy them.
Spiders are dead. 50 gold, still not enough for me to warrant to throw away something. Yeah, there is a
wealth beyond measure.
There is a locked suitcase. Now that is something that I am willing to throw away something for, but for now we'll get it on the way back. We're basically finishing out this bend of the dungeon. I almost stepped on that. 80, 60. We're basically doing this last little elbow of the dungeon because we know we're going to have to backtrack anyway, and this is going to be the longer of the two that I would have had to backtrack through, which is why we're doing the shorter little excursion first down south before we go back up north. High stress, it's a high stress dealing party here. Nice crit by Jeff, actually. I'll definitely dig it. The dodge by Simply Jackson. Alright, these dodges on the back line are getting ridiculous. I mean, as long as they focus everything on the same person, I'm fine with that. Probably should have went for the easy kill, although, never mind, I take that back. My brain unconsciously did the correct play instead of me thinking it out.
Confidence,
because we know that this acolyte is going to die here no matter what, thanks to the bleed by Jeff. I think that, I'd rather buff. It's not enough stress for me to really freak out about yet. There's the kill from Jeff. Fortunately, we did not get an attack on the acolyte before she did that. She got the move. What's your move resist? 50 as well. I guess we'll throw out a heal. 24 crit from Dyrus. Good lord. That's what I wanted to hurry up and kill, and now we've got this whole song and dance routine again, so strap yourself in. This one is not over by a long shot. Try to get the stun on the perfusion, did not happen. I can at least go for the bleed kill on the ectoplasm so that he won't respawn. Start dropping the bleeds here on the large ectoplasm as well. I'd like to, of course, get in range of the of getting finale on. Right now, this is about the best we can do. See if we can get the stun. This time around, we did get the stun. Jeff's just gonna keep on swinging, keep on cutting. I think we can go ahead and weaken them. The lower level ectoplasms don't really do a whole lot of damage, so I'm not... I mean, they're annoying to fight just because they make the fights a little bit longer, but it's not a huge threat, normally. Alright, this time around, I'm going to drop our only holy water. Sorry, holy water.
And
we found a map inside the tent. It could have been a lot worse, actually. You were right, Scrub Victa. And apparently that map showed us nothing, so there's that. I also forgot to move Jeff back, and Dyrus keeps walking on traps. Hoping that's not a trend that continues for very long here. Right, we finally get a bandage of it. A lot of gold.
Laden with loot are often low on.
Gonna get rid of the medicinal herbs here, just because I think that we're going to have enough. We will have enough. I'm gonna kind of skimp on the food rationing for now. We'll go back to this room here. And the reason why I'm doing that is because we're going to get rid of a log and possibly a stack of food as well. Actually, no, we won't be able to get rid of a full stack of food here. But this is where that locked luggage was, and we want to free up some inventory space. So we're doing a little bit of backtracking. Then we're going to camp as soon as we get inside of this room. Let's go ahead and camp Arino. Again, I'm going to be conservative on the food because we have ways of killing the stress. There's no reason to go buck wild. Alright, so let's go ahead and remove the disease. Can we remove the disease? Actually, we cannot. We can't remove any diseases. That's a little bit sad face. It's okay, though. Right, I don't care about nighttime ambush, to be quite honest. Let's go ahead and go for a zealous speech. We've got Dark Strength and... I can't use Dark Strength and Turn Back Time. 20% extra damage would be nice. Yeah, let's go ahead and do it. So we're gonna decrease the... We're gonna increase the strength... The stress on Dyrus, but we're also going to increase the damage by 20% on Simply Jackson. And then from there, we can use one of our... We can use Mockery. Nah, we don't need to use Mockery. We'll just go ahead and use Encourage. It's fine. Again, we can handle the stress that's inflicting Dyrus right now. Victory. So it's not a bad thing. I'd like to use the key on there. Key works, of course. Gold, trinkets and baubles. We'll hold on to the deeds. I probably shouldn't get rid of the deeds because I know that we're going to need them, and we still need them for the blacksmith. So deeds are not going anywhere. And again, every time you camp, unless if you use a particular move by the occultist, a particular camping skill by the occultist, you will always go back to full light coming out of the camp, which typically lasts you. It usually lasts about maybe 3/4 of the way that you've traveled from where you started at, I should say. Surprised and a little bit disappointed at the lack of shovel events. I've got to be honest. 60%. Got Dyrus. The reason why I'm disappointed is just due to the fact that, well, I mean, we bought an extra shovel and we have not had any need to use it yet. Alright, got an anti-venom. I tend to kind of overstock for longer trips. And I wouldn't say that's a problem per se, because normally it works out, but I do find myself getting rid of a lot of things normally. Oh, I'm sorry, Paris gets a crit for one. Sure, I'll take it. I mean, go and get the bleed out as well. So she's down to, I guess she's got to hit her for 3, hit her for 7. Getting the big ups on the leg day. I always think it's, in Darkest Dungeon especially, because you never know what's going to happen, I think it's important to stay prepared and to bring everything and anything that you might think you need. It's always good to bring more than you need. Which I think I've already said in this video, but hey. Let's go ahead and mark you, just because. There we go. Drop the dodge. That way we can almost guarantee a hit. 2 off lethal. We'll go ahead and take care of that leg day. And we're still going to kill the stress on Dyrus. There we go. Dyrus can throw out a weakening curse on this Scratcher this time around to debuff him. Drop his damage a bit. Now the damage has been a problem for this run. Dyrus has been doing a pretty good job at keeping everybody up. 10 damage, 13 damage. Down goes the Scratcher. Easy peasy. I don't care about Fortress. This expedition at least promises success. And immediately another big group here. This time around it's going to be the Madman and his dogs. And another dodge, a double dodge from the back line. Not too happy about that. Let's try to take out one dog at least. There we go. I'd love to take down the Madman as well. I think actually stunning here is probably the better of the two. The Madmen tend to have a pretty large dodge chance, so I'd rather just not have to worry about random diseases or bleeds. That being said, the dogs are usually faster than anyone and everyone in my party anyway, so that might not have been really done anything. Madman got to go twice in a row, which is kind of annoying as well. The dog did die from Jeff's bleed. Then the other dog ended up going anyway. Alright. Alright, game. So there's that. And heal up Simply Jackson for almost all that damage. Madman is now officially dead. Leg Day gets the kill on the dog. I'm hoping that Jeff goes first. He didn't. Great is the weapon that cuts on its own. They might be asking, Sinvicta, where is going to be the next camp? The answer is, I don't know. This is a very, like, despite it being a long dungeon, it's a relatively small dungeon. So we got another surprise event here, which is great. And, I mean, I guess that we're just gonna keep attacking. We don't need to heal anybody. Yeah, I'd like to take down the... There we go. Got the crit. Maybe Sinvicta and Simply can take down one of the scratchers we did. So, yeah, I mean, I'll take it. Killed two of the three in the first round. Unforgiving. It's not like we're fighting maggots here. I mean, we're fighting... You know, scratchers have a fairly high health pool, and I'll take it. Alright, let's go ahead and throw out a curse. Weakening curse on the scratcher, just in case he gets some kind of BS crit. There we go.
Success. So,
so another suitcase here.
Or is it merely a trick of the light?
Tempted to camp again, but let's see what's in here. We have an occultist trinket. That is worth... That's not worth a lot, but that's worth... it's not worth us possibly get... I mean, for the potential treasure we get from the bandages and the anti-venom far outweighs selling one trinket, in my opinion. We got another surprise event. This is where the game would start. If the game were me, this is where I would start complaining. Hey, we got a kill. There we go. And we're just gonna get it. And we're just gonna miss them. It was either that or go for a stun. Obviously, didn't work out the way that I would prefer it to, but nothing usually does in Darkest Dungeon, that's fine. So the dogs are gonna get four attacks off before we're gonna get to do anything. Which again is the reason why they're so annoying to fight, especially when they crit like that. So they got four attacks off, three on the same target. Go ahead and get a bleed out. I think they're going for a stun so we can... The stun killed the dog. Alright, we need to get some heals on GF here. There we go, one heal, he's back up to full. This time I am going to stun. So I want to get rid of some of the stress that we incurred from this ridiculous round. So we know that the dog dies no matter what. We literally don't have to do anything except heal and take care of ourselves. Huge heal by Dyrus. Yeah, let's go ahead and kill the stress on Simply. And yeah, we'll go for another one. Give her a little bit of a heal. Maybe we'll get a crit. We didn't, but that's okay. She got three extra stress relief and actually cleared her stress, so I'm not going to complain about that at
Remind
all.
Remind yourself that overconfidence is a slow and insidious
killer.
We
did proc scouting. At this point, I'm going to get rid of one of the shovels. Well, two of the shovels, because we don't need them anymore. There is a fight down here, so we are forced to have to backtrack a little bit, but that's not a huge deal. Yes, I could be using bandages, by the way, on the bleeding heroes, but it's not a lot of damage, and... We're in no danger of dying from the bleed damage anyway. Not right now.
And now
if it was a little bit more relevant to our survival, then maybe. But right now, I'd rather use the bandages for possible loot. Again, we're not missing out on too much by not taking care of the bleeding. I'm actually going to go offensive here first with Jeff to see if we can burn down at least one of the artilleries, which we were able to do. And if Simply can hit this Iron Swan, which he did and got a crit, we take down the entire back line in one turn. And that's pretty good value. Can't really complain about taking down half of the enemy team in one go. We throw out another bleed on the Scratcher. Fortunately, his 20% was good enough to resist, but that's fine. Gonna heal up on Jeff. And I think going for a stun here would be legit. Especially if it lands, which it did. Alright, let's take care of some stress here. Go grab a heal here on Simply Jackson. And this should be it. I think she'll be going. No, she's not going to go before the Scratcher, which is a little bit sad face, but that's okay. Another 1,000 gold here.
Triumphant pride
precipitates. Yeah, we did scout. Two curios ball. In there. I kind of interested in checking those out. I'll get rid of the crests for now. I really don't want to get rid of the, I really don't want to get rid of deeds. I don't see any reason not to at least go back through here and take a look. So there's another bandage and another locked luggage as well. More gold, more deeds. Okay. It's not bad at all. Another key on the luggage here. So we have one key left. I'm not going to use it because I'm anticipating, hopefully anticipating anyway, scouting out the secret door. I don't know why I decided to go up in the back. I mean, it's the same. It's equidistant from where we were going anyway. It's just, I don't know. The direction really doesn't matter here. We're traveling in a literal square, so it's all right. All right, we did spawn a fight coming back up here to this hallway. It's gonna be three maggots. Yeah, I think we can use this time to heal up. They're maggots, they're not really all that dangerous. They do have a very, very high stun resist, however. And they also have a chance to stun. They deal stress damage with every single hit that they do. We'll attack the maggot that hadn't attacked first, and then we'll attack the one that already did. Didn't gain anything. We did actually we gained a little bit of stress healing, so from the crit from Jeff. And then I think we'll camp once we get inside of here. There's our troubling effigy, which I don't have holy water for anymore. Which again is kind of sad face. And this group is about the worst one you can get inside of the Weald, just because of the double acolytes are really what makes this not terrifying, but a little bit risky to go up against without any proper stress mitigation. So we'll use a battle ballad just to get everyone's speed and crit up. I mean, we're black as pitch right now, so that means that our crits are gonna be a lot higher chance of hitting. Unfortunately, though, we're not getting them. No, we're not getting them on the right mobs, put it that way. Crusader leg day. I was hoping we might get a crit, a miracle crit for the one shot. Didn't happen. Alright. Dyrus with a crit was able to take down one of the acolytes. And Jeff actually takes down the other acolyte, so that worked out very well. I wanted to be greedy and go for Inspiring Cry, but we're about to camp, and I don't think that's necessary. Especially when Jeff can go ahead and get his stress now. I mean, he's only sitting at 32, which is not a huge... That's not a worrying amount of stress. Anything over 50 is worrying. Yeah, we'll get greedy with it. Healed a total of 20 stress, which is nice. Dyrus throwing out the 5 damage. Or 5, not 5 damage, 5 heal, I should say. He healed 5 damage. But then he caused more damage with the bleed, so. Gotta finish off that stress there on Scrub Victa. That's still not a good heal, Dyrus. I mean, 9's okay, don't get me wrong. I mean, 9's better than 5, especially 5 plus the bleed. Alright, we've got a Crusader Trinket, which I'm not going to be able to take. Momentum. Actually, I could have probably thrown away the bandage, but... Yeah. We'll go ahead and we'll use a Feast just to get more inventory space. So, there's that. And I think that we will do a Zealous Speech to reduce stress damage. Yeah, we could do that. Or we could finally go for the 20% damage. This time we'll give it to Scrub Victa. Tiger's Eye. How much respite points? We have 7 left. All right, so we can use Tiger's Eye on Simply. So now her crits are going to be super duper buffed. And then we can go for every rose has its thorn, which clears everyone's stress, including Dyrus's, and also gives us a stress resistance buff. Somehow we got ambushed by 3 maggots. I don't know how realistic this is, but let's see, I can actually move him back, which is nice because now we can use Finale. It's a little bit surprising. It's a pleasant surprise, although I'm not a huge fan of Jeff getting stunned. Because now we can't use Finale this turn. they've stunned two of our party members so far. There's a Holy Lance. How this maggot is faster than Simply Jackson, I will never know, but not a fan.
The ground quakes.
Simply should probably just be getting nothing but crits here for the rest of this dungeon, or at least unless we have more fights than one. And we know there's at least one more room battle we've got to go. Maybe saying, how do you know that, Sinvicto? Well, it's because the dungeon hasn't ended yet. No. Let's try that again, Dyrus. You go in the back. Oh my god, what just happened? Okay, nobody move. I don't know exactly what just transpired there, but it looked like somebody was like inside of the other character model and like stacked up on each other. You can't be doing that to me, game. That's gonna throw me off. Get a bleed out. Dyrus gets the kill with the follow-up. We were not able to go to the Fusilier with Iron Swan before he fired, which is, again, understandable considering that we have the Legendary Bracer on Simply. That's gonna drop her speed by 3, which is not a substantial amount, I might say, but either way. Go ahead and go for
Annihilate.
A dunk on the Cutthroat. Definitely want to use Iron Swan. There's our crit. Alright, we got to delay a little bit here because the amount of ridiculous damage that we've been taking, not only in this fight, but against those stupid maggots. So this is a fight now where I don't mind delaying to the point where we're going to get penalized for it, because we need to heal. We don't need stress mitigation. We can do pretty much at any time. We can't always heal the entire party with an occultist. There's a huge heal there from our crusader. We're just gonna perpetually buff everyone's stats to the highest. A 36 crit heal by Dyrus. Oh my goodness, that's the largest crit heal I think I've seen in a while. Another crit heal from me as well on Jeff. I don't know exactly what's going on, but I kind of like it. He did get the follow-up stun again. Again, we know we're going to get popped for it, and that's fine. Even if he brings reinforcements, I'm also fine with that. This is more about healing up our party rather than worrying about the extra stress. So we were able to come back. We stabilized, able to kill all the stress. Everyone's healed up. We're good to go.
Destroyed.
Yeah, Simply's got 24 and a half crit. Base crit, I might add, right now. So she's going to be hitting pretty hard, pretty often. In another fight here. I'm actually really sad that we have not found the secret door yet. I'm hoping that it procs in the scouting. The crit there by Dyrus. Not enough to kill, however. And unfortunately, the 20% bleed resist won out against Jeff's bleed. Which you'd think I'd be surprised about, but I'm really not. Yeah, we should take out the dog first.
Precision and power.
Took the dog out, that way Sinvicta's in range of taking out that fungal artillery. So we still were able to get the two kills, no matter what, on the first round, but it wasn't in the order that I was expecting. I think a heal here is good. Another huge crit heal by Dyrus. Yeah, there you go. Jester cutting people down. Again, Simply just going off with the crits. I think that we can go for a duel. Actually, if I hit him with a stunning blow, it's going to kill him. So we're going to have to eat this damage. We'll go ahead and throw out a heal. Jeff, it's only one, but that's all right. 8 damage on the Crusaders. Pretty nasty. Dyrus heals himself for 12. He did get the bleed, which is, again, a little bit sad face. Crit. Oh well. It's alright.
As victories mount,
all right,
so
we got,
will resistance.
We've got the emerald here. I'm assuming that we're probably at this point not going to see our anti-venom. I think we can use a... It's not trapped. Herp. It's alright. 25 gold, it's not exactly what I was wanting. Diprock scouting, and there's our secret door. I heard it. It's behind the scouting tile, but there it is. All right, so now I'm excited. Now I'm happier about that.
A victim to the spreading corruption.
So we've got one more fight here inside this room. I'll probably end up fighting this battle too, just because I like fighting in the game. There's even a fountain here as well. Dire is going to open up with the fungal artillery. Is Jeff following up with the non-bleed again? That 20% resist darkest dungeon. That's a humdinger. That's a doozy. Take down one. Not going to be able to take down the second one, however. Which I'm a little bit sad about. I am going to go for a stun, however, on the scratcher that has not attacked yet. That marked target on Sinvicta is a little bit annoying. Not gonna be greedy. Oh my goodness, Dyrus. Just going out of control with these heals. It's a great thing. Did get the bleed, so let's go ahead and go after the weakened fungal scratcher here. That goes the second artillery. Crusader Leg Day is gonna go ahead and take down the scratcher. We don't have, nobody's got any stress right now. There's not much for Jeff to do other than just keep tossing out the bleeds. That wasn't a great deal, Dyrus. Let's try this again. I'm just gonna be silly with it now. It's getting a little greedy. If I get punished for this, it's totally my bad. Now we're just getting silly. There we go. There's sapphires there, which I definitely do want. That's gonna be it. We're not done yet because we gotta go to the secret door, and I still want to fight there. So I tell you what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna see what this fight is first. Come back, tap the fountain if we get any stress from this that we haven't already mitigated, and then we'll end it inside of the secret door. Another nice heal by Dyrus, who's done an excellent job healing. Some of the best occultist heals I've seen in a long time. Not gonna mitigate the stress yet. I want to make sure we get down the occultist first. There you go, she is dead. Dodge by Simply. We're not even getting the benefits of the Moon Cloak right now. Alright, so just topping off that stress here. Down goes the Acolyte. And yeah, there we go. Much better heal there on Jeff. I think going for a stun is fine. We prevent this one from attacking. I could have probably went for a
well struck.
A wicked hack on the back scratcher there, and then tried to use Invicta for the stun, but that's okay. There's multiple ways that I could have done that. And of course, none of which matters because this dungeon is very, very quickly over. One off lethal. Yeah. Alright, you got this, Dyrus. He hit for zero, Dyrus! The one time we just needed to do one damage, Dyrus. We can't even do damage until Simply comes back around. Okay, I can do damage. There we go. That was silly. Little bit silly there. Alright, we know we're not gonna need shovels, so we're just gonna get rid of that. And let's go end it inside of the we didn't even tap the fountain, we didn't have to. I mean, it's just gonna be another flawless run here, so. And what do we have inside the ancient artifact? We got ourselves a whole lot of gold. Alright, so take care of that. And yeah, even though two deeds kind of stick out. Two deeds versus 250 gold. No thanks. All right. Well, that's exactly what we needed. It's a good dark run there for a long run. We also get the Sun Cloak, and we almost broke 20 G's. 25 gold off. Ironically, if I hadn't gotten rid of one of our deeds, we would have broken it. But yeah. It's okay. Not worried about it. We got the Wield Scrounger and the Ruins Adventurer. So I'm going to wrap it up there. Again, I hope you all enjoyed this long run.
Can you feel it?
I am going to do a little bit of mitigation and house cleaning as far as stress, as well as the disease stuff goes. And yeah, I'm going to wrap it up there. Thank you for watching, everyone. Of course, check out my Patreon page, patreon.com/invicta, if you'd like to take that extra step in supporting myself. I do appreciate it, but of course, none of that is non-optional. Of course, you always have the option not to do anything like that. I just appreciate the love and the support, and yeah, it's awesome. Super awesome. Super amazing wagon adventure. Awesome. Until next time, so long, everybody!